What's going on YouTube? So yeah, we spent a lot of time on the previous screen trying to get everything right. And what I actually realized was, and the way I came about solving it was, Hanky had previously said to me that I wasn't starting far enough to the right. So I was trying to go more to the right, but what I was doing as I was jumping, I was holding the diagonal down on my start and my jump. And what occurred to me was when I got to the middle platform, I could do the wave dash on a much shorter platform for the simple reason that I was just jumping straight up before I was doing my diagonal dash. So that's when I then started on the big platform on the left-hand side to kind of factor in just a straight up dash before I did that. And within a couple, like 10, 15 minutes, I was then starting to chain the dash together. And then about 10, 15 minutes or so after that, I actually started to get the jump and we actually made it to the end. So yeah, glad to be off that screen, but we are on to the next one. So onwards we go. To whatever. Oh, have I got to get the bird? I feel I got to get the bird. Okay, so I feel like I got to wave dash into the bird. That's what we're going to go for here. If I can. Hey, don't you want me to help you? Don't you want to see me again, Granny? I don't understand. Are you testing me? Are you just afraid to ask for help? Maybe part of me was right. Maybe it's just a bird. Unless... the bird doesn't want me to save Granny! It's trying to stop me, just like part of me. I'm alone up here. Well, we don't need their help, right, Granny? Don't worry, I won't give up on you. I'll catch the stupid bird and set you free. That's the spirit, Madeline. Oh, this music. This music is starting to sound much like classic Celeste that we're used to. Okay, so then I'm going to do... okay, I think I got to wall kick off that bit. Okay. Yeah, something like that. That's what I got to do. There we go. Good start. I guess, but then I got a wave dash. I really need to chain these wave dashes together. Because, yeah, we're not going to, or else we're not going to get across the last one. We got this. If I can just chain the last one together, that is. There we go, look, I'm a wave dash master. Oh my goodness, we got the things from Core. But I need to keep my dash, so... wave dashing is definitely the key to this. Is it? It's weird, it's kind of like... put me off at like a weird angle. I thought you was able to jump off them. Lost my grab. Yeah, I can jump off them. Maybe I just need to time my jump better. Maybe. Oh god. That's not gonna help. Alright, so I just need to get over there. I also need to move my chat bar. Please. There we go. Music to me is pretty bizarre. It's kind of like a cross, but to me at the minute it sounds like a cross between Celeste and Legend of Zelda. It's really bizarre. Definitely got that Celeste feel to it though. Definitely. Am I meant to kick off there? Am I meant to go for the platform elevator things? Like I did the very first time I made it across here. That's the question. I could probably do it. But the fact that there's the other thing there as well makes me question. I think, if I remember rightly, with core, the trick with these was like the lower you got on them, the more height you got, like later on, when you did your jump off. So I think like it's almost like a pixel perfect frame thing to get the crystal as well. Got to dash like straight off for a start. Maybe we need to. I was thinking you maybe don't even need to like go across all the way around. You could grab the crystal and come back down. But man. In other news, I see that TGH has already been speedrunning. He's got his run on this down to 19 minutes, I think, at the minute, which is mad. Celeste Pros at the best. Left and jump straight up for start there. That's where I'm going wrong. I think that's what I gotta do. I don't know, I'm still undecided whether or not that's what I gotta do, or whether I've actually gotta use the platforms. as I said to Hanky when I was trying that other level for a few hours the other day, the corner boosts, edge boosts, whatever you want to call them, they're one thing which are particularly tricky and I kind of struggle with. So, but hey, I'm getting good with these wave dashes. I wonder if there's something up there. But I have definitely not got enough stamina to get up there, so we're not going to waste time trying to find a way up there. That would just be silly. I'm holding left fractionally too long. Not enough height there. I'm not sure, like, grabbing and kicking off that block is actually very effective. Unless it's meant to, like, serve as a purpose to keep a dash somehow further up. Because to get on the bottom of those, I'll call them travelators for now, I don't mind the gladiators. To get on the bottom of that travelator, you have to use both dashes. Far too quickly. Yeah, okay, so I can do it without going to the other block. Let's time them jumps. Kind of seems like a bit of a red herring. I just need to get like low enough on the block for a start to be able to get enough height when I jump off the travelator. Also not jump too early. And girls, we got this. What I don't got is sound anymore because my headphones have just desynced from my Bluetooth adapter. I'll be back in a minute. Nope, it won't. We're playing soundless. You guys can still hear the sound, but I can't. There we go, we're back. It's just getting that like pixel perfect. It's an age-old thing, right, with Celeste. You hit a trick pixel perfect. What's going on, Chuns? How you doing? How are you in Shanty tonight? You start to hit a strat pretty perfectly, and then you get to, like, to the next bit, and you have to learn something else, and then the bit that you learned perfectly before just goes completely out of the window. There we go. We got it. We got it. Doing good. Good to hear, my man. Are you playing more Shanty tonight? I don't think there's anything that way. I'm guessing you could do that one of two ways, because there's blocks there that you could do edge boosts off. I guess you could probably kick without the need to... it looks like you could probably kick across there without the need to use boosts. I leave it tomorrow night. Oh, good. Had that onesie on yet? Alright, what are we going to do here? So we've got to use Kevin. Kevin's going to hit that block. Come back. Do we go back with Kevin? Maybe we ride Kevin all the way first. Jump through the top of that gap there. Got to be very careful though, because it's got the hotel kind of touch me once and I turn into dust and kill you kind of things on top of it. So I'm thinking it's got to, we're going to ride Kevin to the end first. And then when he comes back, we dart up to get that crystal, get back on top of him, get the button. Cause him to then go across again, and right as he gets to the end, we use our dash to go through the dream block, I think. It's getting through there though, isn't it? Yeah, okay, so we've got to get through there. We've got to make that crumble. That's the issue. You never played Celeste, I take it then, Chuns. It's a great kind of like old kind of platformy game. It's like proper sort of platforming fun. Where there is a lack of fun, because a lot of the time it stresses you the fuck out. Alright. But yeah, this is the recently released Chapter 9 expansion. Thing is, I don't know how to... Alright, so what... Can I go for the button... I can't go for the button first, because it's too high. I need a double dash to get that. So we've definitely got to go... that way first. Oh. You want me to do a wave dash, don't you? Oh my goodness, this is brutal. So, I think what this wants me to do is basically do a wave dash, because wave dash keeps your like jump arc low. So I've got to bounce down, start the block off, wait till it's gone past the first bit, jump off on the top, do a wave dash through the gap. Oh my god. That was not the right thing to do either. Because I think then I can grab this side of the block, then jump up and... Maybe I'm overcomplicating this. But I gotta get up there though, that's the problem. Huh. I don't think I can go quick enough to do that. I don't know what else I could do. When Kevin hits that block, he will... The only thing is I get the dash back and I dash up quickly. Maybe that's a thing I could do. Oh, I can just duck under it. Well, that makes things a hell of a lot easier. Jeez. Okay, so then I go... Okay. Possibly got to save a dash, though. It's classic Nock. Overthink the obvious. Okay, so then when I drop down, I gotta grab the edge of the block. I can't land on top of the block. I don't think. Oh, man. Ah! Well, I think we're just about to work this out now. If I can only stop. Oh, yeah, okay. I was just about to say, I think I need to. I don't think I need to actually move off that block to get on that thing, but the problem is, if I stay on there, the game registers I'm still stood on there, and it turns all of the, kind of like, you can only stand here once area, into, you've already stood on me. Which is not good. Maybe I could have got away with that. Ah! Almost had it. Alright, we got this. Come on, Nock. I believe in the power. Duck. Why are you not grabbing onto that block, Madeline? Not sure how I managed to kind of like scathe past that one. I need to pretty much go as soon as I can't. I don't want to delay. I need to pretty much go straight away. Oh, I could have dashed. I landed on the platform. I could have dashed. That was stupid. I had my dash back and I didn't use it. Because I didn't realise I had my dash. And I can't dash up. Oh, I totally forgot what I was doing there. Then how do I get my dash back? That's problematic. I think if I jump from that side to try and save some of the surface area on this Kevin block, I think I've got enough height to make the jump to the bottom. Oh my god, I did it, and then I fucked it up at the end. Excuse my French. There we go. Alright. What have we got here? So we're only going to get one dash back at any point along here. Okay, I think I've got to jump on that. Wave dash off. Oh my goodness. I don't think I've got a wave dash off it. Do a... yeah. Really corner boost off this one. Something about, I can't really hold grab here, but there's something about not being able to hold grab which screws me up. And then I gotta do the same again. Okay. difference being, I'm gonna grab that block and jump straight off it. I'm kind of really struggling to like grasp when to actually hit that block, which is weird, really. It's like I'm not pressing the right direction today, just because I'm like... Almost. Could have maybe saved that. Massively unintended, but... Not always about being intended, is it? It's about getting to the end in this game. I'm dashing twice. Rather than jumping. It's the crystal. I didn't have an angle on my thing there, so I just kind of like fell to a standstill. But other than that, that was pretty much it. There we go. Success! Alright. Moving blocks. So moving block, that's going to give me a dash second off there. Okay. I think I gotta get up there, land on that. I think I gotta do this with one dash though. That's the thing. Straight up. And where do we kick off that? Oh, I'm not hitting that though. I'm not re-grabbing the block for some reason, I don't know why. So I'm pretty sure when I hit the second button, that's going to move the block over enough to grab that other crystal, right? I think I need to work on doing this though with like one dash. Which is the worrying thing. Why isn't Madeline grabbing? That's the thing I don't get. So if Madeline just grabbed this, then... So I'm running out of stamina. Let's just hit the spikes. Great strategy, Madeline. So that sort of puts me back into thinking, do I need to kick off this block? Ah! Okay. Kicking off that block. But without using the second dash. Ah, messed it up then. But yeah, I got it. We got it, boys. We got it. Wave dash, corner boost, to there, corner boost, oh my god. Turning around though and getting like the other direction, which is going to be the difficult part for me. Ah, why did I do that? To do the execution, just gonna need a little bit of practice, just the last bit, because I've got to kind of come down the left side but edge boost off the right side of that one. Like that. Oh no, I can't hit this one. Thing is though, when I get around here, I'm probably going to want to try and angle as much as I can across to here. I could just drop down and dash across to get the double crystal again. That's probably the safe strat, right? And then you hold grab. Madeline doesn't freaking grab onto the wall. What the hell? It's the direction change that makes it such a difficult boost. This screen out of. Am I complicating matters, actually? There might be an easier way. Oh my god, there is such an easier way. Alright. Nock, overcomplicating the shit out of things. Find an easier way, but now I can't do it. If I could maybe dash as soon as I get that pink crystal, I might be able to stop myself from hitting them spikes. Maybe. Thank you. There we go. Oh, but I need to... Yeah. I need to be able to edge boost and wall kick, or wall, sorry, not probably edge kick, but wall kick off that ledge. That's not going to get over to where I need to be. Quick. Excuse me. Oh, then I've got a kick off there, maybe? Too high on that platform, which is screwing me up. Yeah, I gotta get relatively low on that one. So I've gotta jump earlier off the first one, I think. Unless I kick off this one as well. Then that doesn't come up. I need to grab it to actually activate it, so... I'm guessing I do need to grab onto it rather than kick off it. Unless I grab the other one first, then come back down, maybe? Trying to think. Kick off there, kick off there, onto that one. See, if I did that, I wouldn't even need the other. I could do kick and a kick over to that side. Hmm. Because if I got, I was just thinking, if I got onto the other one, I wouldn't even need that dash crystal, that stamina crystal. I don't think I've got enough, though, to do a kick off the second one from where it is, because there's too many spikes around it. Alright. Didn't need it. Oh, we got bubbles. Okay. Let's see what we've got to do here. Until I leave the bubble. Where do I go from there, though? It's a mystery. I gotta do an edge boost. Spikes. That's the last one up. We got this. Wave dashing, the thumb killer.
There we go.
Made it. All right. Oh my god. So I hope it doesn't get my dash back. Where to go from here though. Okay, that could work. That could work. Ah. I've just got to... Can't waste a dash at all on this. Just have to go. And that last jump out of that block is crucial. Gotta get high enough. Too high. Madeline. Quite low on that block, I think. They've got to be quite low on both of those blocks. Oh, we had it. So yeah, low is the key. High at the top, low at the bottom. There we go. All right, we've got the moving dream blocks. Checking the secrets, but I'll jump out of them. If I lose my dash at any point, then I've got to start again. Oh my God. This is quite actually simple. I'm just making a right hash of it. I need to stop dashing diagonal up. I actually need to jump out of the dream block as well. There we go. Can I stop dashing diagonal upright, please, Madeline? Too low. Didn't wait long enough. wait too long. Didn't grab the block. Oh, you pig. It should be pretty easy once I get to that point, though, because it's just about timing that last jump. Too high on the freaking spike. Oh, you tit. I shouldn't have dashed, I should have just jumped out the block. I'm not jumping out the block at all now. I'm pressing jump too early. There we go. Jump out the block. Well, I can do it. I just need to put it all together in one freaking solid run. Didn't get the jump out the block. This is when like frustration starts kicking, because you know you can do it. It just comes down to your timing. I only need to do a diagonal up dash through that last block, and that'll put me in exactly the right position. Goodness. What have we... Okay, so we send the block. Possibly do a wave dash. Oh my good God. And then I gotta do a jump over and then grab onto the block. Right, I've got a bit more time though. I don't need to be as quick as I first thought. So that's why I need to kick off the block. Not actually kick off. Hold up. Timing it though, isn't it? That was kind of it. I think I was a little bit late there. Too early there. That would have been it if I'd have... Get in the diagonal. Thank you. wondering if that's like a better way to time this. Like all the way around the block. Sort of thing. Like it is a good way to time this. I don't think I'm kicking off. I think doing a corner boost on the edge of it is better. I think I'm getting more success when I like hit the edge of it. It was still a pretty tough trick to pull off. My fingers are all over the place at the minute trying to get this edge boost sorted. Fingers are starting to get tired tonight. Play for a little bit longer, and then we'll switch it up to a bit of Final Fantasy VIII for an hour or so. I'm quite back into Final Fantasy VIII at the minute, which is quite nice. Almost at the end of Disc 1 on that as well. The equivalent of Disc 1 anyway. Can't seem to. It's the timing now. That's too early. That was like right, but I just didn't quite have enough height. And then I get all finger and thumb and mess everything up. Just again, it's like hitting that frickin' small window to kick off the corner at the bottom of this moving block. It's got to be like pixel perfect. It seems. Unless I'm massively overcomplicating things here. Face pulling territory now as well. I can feel myself pulling faces. Alright, I'm going to leave it there for tonight. I think we made some very, very good progress though on in total. You know, we seem to fly through a load of screens. I don't know, I think we must have done at least a dozen screens. Think, don't know, maybe I'm being a bit dramatic, but yeah, the wave dashing thing now is just like second nature. It's relatively easy to do. I'm rather kind of got the hang of it, and like I'm doing now. Like Hanky said, you have to learn to chain it. There was that one room where if I hadn't have learned to chain it, I wouldn't have done it because of the moving blocks. What's quite interesting though, I haven't needed to use it yet like that, but keeping your doing it over multiple screens is quite difficult. But we haven't had to do that. So, yeah, thank you very much, everybody. We'll be back tomorrow with some more Celeste. So make sure you stick to the channel if you want to see some more Chapter 9 action. Hopefully we'll get past that screen after we've sort of had a bit of a break from Celeste. Hopefully everything will go a little bit better. But until next time, I'm Nock. You've been awesome. See ya!